ओम महागणपते नमः, ओम नारायणाय नमः। टुडे वी शैल सी द स्टैंसा नंबर 38, विष्णु सहस्रनाम श्लोकः। पद्मनाभो अरविन्दाक्षः पद्मगर्भः शरीरभृद् महर्धिरुद्धो वृद्धात्मा महाक्षो गरुड़ध्वजः। पद्मनाभो पद्मनाभः प्लस अरविन्दाक्षः। पद्मनाभः नेवल ऑफ पद्मम मीन्स फ्रॉम हिज नेवल द लोटस इज ग्रोइंग एंड द क्रिएशन टेक्स प्लेस फ्रॉम हिज नेवल, दैट इज व्हाट भीष्मा सेज। नाउ अरविन्दाक्षः, अरविन्दाक्षः नॉर्मली पीपल विल इंटरप्रेट एज अ लोटस आइड गॉड, बट एक्चुअली इफ यू गो टू डीप संस्कृतम, अरह इन मैस्कुलिन मीन्स अ व्हील और ऑल्सो अ स्पोक ऑफ द व्हील यू कैन से, एंड इन एडजेक्टिव फॉर्म इट सेज वेरी स्विफ्ट एंड स्पीडी विल, अरम दे से जनरली, एंड विंद इन द एडजेक्टिव फॉर्म और इन द वर्बल फॉर्म मीन्स अहम विंदामि विंदते एंड ऑल उभय पदिन यू विल गेट आई एम गेटिंग ऑब्टेनिंग रीचिंग फाइंडिंग अ लॉट ऑफ मीनिंग्स इन द एज पर द यूसेज, बट एक्चुअली द रियल मीनिंग विंद डीप संस्कृत मीन्स अ पर्टिकुलर अवर ऑफ द डे द अवर्स is Vindha. Now why I am coming to this, I will tell you. Akshaha, okay, normally understood meaning is I. The Akshaha means actually the beam of a balance. You have the balance, you know, the weighing scale. You have the beam and you have a pivot there which holds the beam. That is Akshaha, that is axis. Now why I am taking you is because Bhishma describes Bhagavan as a universal phenomena, universal character. Now here Bhagavan is a balancing force of this universe. That is why he is called Aravindakshaka. Ara means, I told you, the wheel. Now, why the wheel? Everything is rotating only. There's, your earth rotates around its own axis. Araha means also axis. Akshaha means axis. The earth rotates on its own axis. The sun rotates itself on its own axis. Then the nine planets go around the sun. Then the sun with these nine planets go around the Milky Way. There is a central called black hole. And that gravity is attracting. So every galaxy, every sun, that's why Bhagavan is also called Chakrayudhapani. The entire stars, suns, crores of galaxies rotate within its own axis and spin around the other. So Aravindakshaha is one who maintains the balance of the galaxies while they are rotating. It is my meaning. Because Bhishma, when he wants to praise God, lot of places he says lotus eyed God, but this is the meaning, the fundamental meaning. Because Bhagavan Narayana is a creator. Otherwise, why they use these Aravindakshaha? We have lot of words, Padmakshaha. We have lot of words. So therefore, this Aravindakshaha is his meaning. Now next we shall see Padma Garbha. Garbha is the Garbhapai. You know, it is. Which is the womb of the womb, generally say, where the creations are done, progeny, and Padma is lotus. So from Bhagavan's navel, I would say, that's what he means, the golden embryo. So the golden womb, he has a golden womb which gives out the beautiful lotus, and Brahma is there. He created the world. So the universe is such a beautiful place. We admire our own Himalayas or Alps, but the universe per se must be very, very beautiful. Some of the pictures of ISRO or NASA, you can see how even in our own small Mars or in Venus, how it looks like. Fantastic. Sharira Brit. Brit means one who carries, possesses. Brit. Shariram. Of all the bodies, any body, not only man, humans, but also animals, also sun, the moon, the stars, the insects, the small unicellular insects, anything. Mahar Riddhihi. Maha means Maha. Riddhihi is in Sanskrit means anything Riddhi, Riddhihi. Siddhi, Riddhi, they say. It's prosperous. It's bliss. It's prosperous in all fields. Not only in wealth, not only in intelligence, not only in character. In bliss, it's a total prosperity. It's a beautiful, positive, vibe word. And Riddha, the next one, is one who has the prosperity is called Riddha. Riddhi is also a feminine form. Riddhihi, if it is, like Harihi. But again, Bhishma says he is that Riddha, the prosperous. Vriddha Atma. Vriddha means old men. Generally, Vriddha in Sanskrit means old men. Vriddha, old man. But Atma is a soul. Vriddha Atma means the ancient soul. That's what. The applied meaning is ancient. The Vyakarana meaning is the old soul, but the applied meaning is the ancient soul. Now, Maha Akshaha. Here I am saying Maha. Maha Akshaha means Maha plus Akshaha or Maha plus Akshaha. Akshaha, I would say only as a, you can say I, but he is only the wheel. He is the biggest wheel. Aksha also means wheel. Aksha also means axles. So Akshaha, I would only take it as a wheel. He is the biggest wheel. He is the Maha Akshaha. Garuda Dvajaha. Garuda, you know, the biggest flying bird, Garuda. Dvajaha is the flag. Dvajastambam, we say. Kodimaram in Tamil, they say. When we enter a temple. So, he is, in his flag, he has the Garuda, simple, signifying that energy is always created by movement. When you flap the wings, the energy is created, you fly. The Garuda flies like that, when it flaps its wing. When it doesn't flap its wing, if it flaps its wings, it stays on the ground peacefully or perching itself on a branch of a tree. But once it starts flapping, it flies, energy is created. So Bhagavan is using the Garuda to signify that it is creating energy perennially. That is why it symbolizes. So this is the meaning. Now I shall give you the numberings. Now 346 is Padmanabha, 347 is Aravindaksha, 348 is Padma Garbha, 349 is Sharira Brith, 350 is Mahar Riddhihi, 351 is Riddha, 352 is Vriddhatma, 353 is Mahakshaha, 354 is Garida Dvajaha. Om Dirghashman Bhava Dirgha Sumangali Bhava Sarvavyadi Nivarana Praptirastu Sarvaishwaryam Avivirdir Bhavatu Sarvamangalani Bhavantu Tadastu Tathastu Tathastu. Om